So let's now start discussion of a special case of determinant, which is given by question number 7 in our assignment. If PBC, AQC, ABR equals to 0, then find the value of P upon P minus A plus Q upon Q minus B plus R upon R minus C. Okay. So how to use this determinant, which is equal to 0, in finding the value of P upon P minus A plus Q upon Q minus B plus R upon R minus C. So first we will write it in our page. The given determinant is first row P, B, C. P, B, C. The second row is A, Q, C. Third row is A, B, R equals to 0. And we have to find P upon P minus A plus Q upon Q minus B plus R upon R minus A. Means we have to first simplify this determinant by using the properties of determinant. So what should we do first of all? If we want to bring zeros, C minus C is 0, we know that. So it can be brought if we use R1 operated as R1 minus R2. So P minus A will be there. Check there. P minus A is in our question. B minus Q is there and its inverse is Q minus B, which is also in our denominator. And third is C minus C 0, which is very important in the discussion of determinant. Again, if we perform the operation R2 operated as R2 minus R3, then it is again giving one of the 0, A minus A. Q minus B is there, we have to bring it. C minus R, and this is the introduction of C minus R. R minus C is already there. Next is A, B, R equals to 0. Now if we take this P minus A common from first column, Q minus B common from second column, R minus C common from third column. First column because P minus A upon P minus A 1, 0 upon P minus A 0, A upon P minus A is nothing, it is A upon P minus A. Second, when we take Q minus B common from B minus Q, it is minus 1. Q minus B upon Q minus 1, 1. B upon Q minus B. From the third, if we take R minus C common, 0. C minus R upon R minus C, minus 1. And R upon R minus C equals to 0. Now, to bring more zeros in the same line, if we do the operation, C1 operated as, C1 is 1, 0, A upon P minus A. C1 operated as C1 plus C2 plus C3. So this 1 minus 1 plus 0 is 0. 0 plus 1 minus 1 is 0. And A upon P minus A plus B upon Q minus B plus R upon R minus C will be there as the third element. Means we are operating what? C1 operated as C1 plus C2 plus C3. So first column, 0. 1 minus 1 plus 0, 0. 0 plus 1 minus 1 is 0. And then a upon b minus a plus b upon q minus b plus r upon r minus b. Second column is minus one, and b upon q minus b. Third column, 0, minus 1, r upon r minus c. Now, if we bring this first column in place of third column, it is equal to 0, first we write. And in this third element, if we assume it to be capital A, as it is very difficult to write it again. And third row is transferred to the third place. First column crosses the two rows. It is minus 1, 1, b upon q minus b. Second column becomes the first column. Third column, 0, minus 1, r upon r minus c is the second column. And third column, 0, 0. And the last element is a upon, I am writing it again completely, though it is very large, a upon p minus a plus b upon q minus b plus r upon r minus c equals to 0. Now, it is a lower triangular matrix, so its value will be obtained, determinant can be obtained by the product of three diagonal elements, minus 1 into minus 1 plus 1 into a upon p minus a plus b upon q minus b plus r upon r minus c equals to 0. So after getting this, look at the problem which we have to bring, p upon p minus a. So how to bring p upon p minus a when we have a upon, I am doing it in the same page by making a division, as we have almost approached to the answer. So a upon p minus a, but we have to bring p upon p minus a. So if this a is written as, to bring p, p plus a minus p, means we have added p, we have subtracted p, over p minus a. Now when we separate it, p upon p minus a, plus a minus p upon p minus a, and a minus p upon p minus a will become minus 1. In second element, we have to bring q upon q minus b. So add q. So it is q plus b and subtract q over q minus b. So q upon q minus b, which we have to bring, plus b minus q upon q minus b is minus 1. And third element is already there. R upon r minus c equals to 0. Now when we separate it, p upon p minus a plus a minus p upon p minus a plus q upon q minus b plus b minus q upon q minus b, which is minus 1, plus r upon r minus c equals to 0, implies p upon p minus a, p upon p minus a is the first term, minus 1, a minus p upon p minus a is minus 1, plus q upon q minus b b minus q upon q minus b is again minus 1. plus r upon r minus c equals to 0. And we have to find the value of p upon b minus a plus q upon q minus b plus r upon r minus c equals to this minus 1 and minus 1 minus 2 is transferred to right hand side. So the answer is 2. Very easy. Given that first row PBC, second row AQC, ABR is a determinant which is equal to 0. And using this value, find the value of P upon P minus A plus Q upon Q minus B plus R upon R minus C. So simply we have used the same principle as we are using in all the determinants by bringing 0. How to bring zeros? So if we subtract R1 as R1 minus R2, C minus C is 0, B minus Q is there, and P minus A is there, and we have to bring P minus A, Q minus B in our question. So it is there. Then again, R2 is operated as R2 minus R3. So A minus A 0, Q minus B and C minus R will be there. And we have to bring Q minus B as well as C minus I as well as R minus C in our question. So they are there. Okay. So it implies when we take P minus A common from the first column, it is 1. 0 upon P minus A 0. A upon P minus A, A upon P minus A. Now second column, if we take Q minus B common, B minus Q upon P minus Q minus, when we have taken Q minus B common, B minus Q upon Q minus B is minus 1, Q minus B upon Q minus B is 1, B upon Q minus B, then third column 0 upon R minus C is 0, C minus R upon R minus C is minus 1, R upon R minus C is 0. So 1 minus 1, 0, 0, 1 minus 1, A upon P minus A, B upon Q minus B, R upon R minus C is there. If we now perform C1 operated as C1 plus C2 plus C3, 1 minus 1 plus 0 will be 0, 0 plus 1 minus 1 will be 0, and A upon P minus A plus B upon Q minus B plus R upon R minus C will be there. Next two columns will be remain as will be written as it is. Again, if we cross third column and bring it to the first column, the next column is first column and the second column are shifted to become the second column and the third column. First column is shifted to the third place. So first column becomes the third column. 0, 0, A upon P minus A, B upon P minus B, R upon P minus B. And second column becomes the first column. Minus 1, 1, B upon Q minus B. Third column becomes the second column. 0, minus 1, R upon R minus C. The result will be same. Equals to 0. So the final result is obtained now as it is the lower triangular determinant. So its value is obtained by the product of its diagonal elements. Minus 1 into minus 1 plus 1 into A upon P minus A plus B upon Q minus B plus R upon R minus C equals to 0. As we have to bring P upon P minus A, but we have A upon P minus A. So first we add P. So when we separated P upon P minus A. But if we add P, we have to subtract P also. So P plus A minus P over P minus A. So P upon P minus A plus A minus P upon P minus A will be there. Again, we have to bring Q upon Q minus B, but we have B upon Q minus B. So we add Q and subtract Q. So Q upon Q minus B plus B minus Q upon Q minus B, which will become minus 1 in next line, plus R upon R minus C. We have to bring and it is already there, equals to 0. So in next line, P upon P minus A minus 1 plus Q upon Q minus B minus 1 plus R upon R minus C equals to 0. These minus 1 and minus 1 are transferred to the right hand side. So P upon P minus A plus Q upon Q minus B plus R upon R minus C equals to 2, which is the answer and which we have to find. I think it must be clear to you. Otherwise, ask it without any hesitation in comment box.